Nader.
Thank you.
20th edition of the Virginia International Tattoo is dedicated to the 3 million men and women of America's armed forces who have protected our freedom during the past 20 years. They stood tall and proud during a turbulent time, and along with our NATO allies, they continue to stand guard today. Over those 20 years, more than 13,000 performers from 28 nations have come together to present this tattoo, which celebrates the joy of music and dance and friendship among nations. And every one of these performers is shared with over 400,000 audience members, owes a unique debt to those 3 million Americans and their families. Over the past two decades, our men and women in uniform have continually been called upon for peacekeeping missions throughout the Middle East, Africa, and Eastern Europe. They have guarded our embassies and evacuated our citizens when war and rebellion were only two streets away. They have stood watch in the Sinai Desert in Bosnia, Kosovo, Albania, and Serbia, in East Timor, in Syria, Somalia, and Yemen. Then came the tragic events of September 11, 2001, which shocked our nation and the world. Within weeks, we had tracked the origins of the attacks in Afghanistan. A young American stepped forward by the thousands to enlist. Allied retribution was swift and deadly. The terrorists and their Taliban government host were swept from power in exile. That was the beginning of the longest war in American history. Conflict that began in October of 2001 and continues today. Over 2 million American and Allied troops will be called on to fight in Afghanistan in Operation Enduring Freedom and in Iraq in Operation Iraqi Freedom, our nation's second largest war. With an all-volunteer military, our troops would have to deploy to combat over and over again. Over the years, there have been countless acts of daily heroism on patrols in and over the rugged mountains and valleys of Afghanistan, and in the cities, towns, and deserts of Iraq. That heroism often goes unseen and unheralded by all but the few who were there at a sudden and deadly moment in time. Although we have wound down our involvement in Iraq to small numbers of trainers and advisors, and the Americans still in Afghanistan are likewise focused on training and advising, the danger of duty there and elsewhere around the world is still very real. In a nation with a population of 320 million, less than 2 million were in uniform today. Less than 1% of all the serving and sacrificing of all of their families. How great a debt we owe to those men and women. Soldiers are not motivated by money or by glory. They see too little of each. They stand ready to lay down their lives for the sake of their homeland and for those who stand beside them in battle. Their country calls and they answer. They ask for nothing more than the opportunity to serve as their parents did in Vietnam and their grandparents did in World War II and Korea. This, we hope, will remain unchanged for 1,000 years. Watch an infantry platoon moving through the heat of a tropical jungle or a barren desert. Their eyes swivel, alert for signs of an ambush or an IED. They watch each other too, alert for signs of comrades faltering under the burden of a 70-pound pack in the boiling heat. They are swift to relieve them of their load and to lend a shoulder to keep them watching. The good book says, "Great love hath no man down his life for the sake of another." The more than 3 million Americans who have served over the past 20 years have carried that greater love in their hearts. We can never thank them enough for all they have done and all they have endured, but we can try. We thank all of you who wear the uniform today and all the veterans who went before you. We love you for all you have given, are given, and will give for our country. And finally, now, please, everyone, rise as we remember all those who are no longer with us because they paid the ultimate price in service to the nation.
Thank you. Please be seated.